When we have force vectors drawn in three dimensions, breaking them down to Cartesian vector form will help out a lot. So we're going to learn how we can break forces into components in Cartesian form, how to add them, and find the magnitude. Most of this I will explain through examples, but before we get there, let me just go over some basics to keep in mind. When we write a force in Cartesian form, we use I, j, and k components, also called Cartesian unit vectors. So let's say we have these three components. We write the x component using I, the y component using j, and the z component using k. If we want to figure out the magnitude of a Cartesian vector, we just take each term, square it, add it all together, and then take the square root. This will become much clearer with examples. Lastly, let's say we have a Cartesian coordinate system like this, and have a vector drawn like this. We need a way to represent the angles created between each of the axes and the force vector. The x-axis angle is represented by the alpha symbol, the y-axis angle by the beta symbol, and the z-axis angle by the gamma symbol. These angles are called the coordinate direction angles. We can find these angles using these equations. Let's get to some examples to see how we can use what we learned to break forces into components. Let's take a look at this problem, where we need to express each force in Cartesian vector form and determine the resultant force and the coordinate direction angles. Looking at the diagram, we can see that forces F2 and F3, the angles, are coordinate direction angles. One way to easily tell is to look at what these angles represent. If we focus just on force F2, we see that there are three angles given, one with respect to the x-axis, another with respect to the y-axis, and lastly, one with respect to the z-axis. We also see that these angles are measured between the tail of the vector and the axis. So these are coordinate direction angles. The same goes for force F3. For force F1, it's on the zy plane, and we're given one angle, so we can use sine and cosine to break its components. So let's focus on just force F1 and write it in Cartesian form. The y component is opposite to the angle, so it'll be sine, and the z component is adjacent to the angle, so it'll be cosine. If you forgot how to do this or need a refresh, please see the description for the addition of coplanar forces. Also remember, x components are represented by I, y components are represented by the letter j, and the z components are represented by the letter k. Let's simplify. Since force F1 doesn't have x component, it'll be 0. Next, we will focus on force F2. Since the angles are coordinate direction angles, all we need to do is multiply the force by the cosine of the angle with respect to each axis. So for the x component, we're looking for the angle between the force and the x-axis. For the y component, it's the angle between the force and the y-axis. And lastly, for the z component, it's the angle between the force and the z-axis. Whenever it's coordinate direction angles, we always use cosine. Let's simplify. We see that our k component is negative. We can verify that with our diagram, since we see that the force is below the xy plane. In other words, the z component is along the negative z axis. Now for force F3. It's pretty similar to before. The only problem is the angle between the force and the y axis. One thing you have to make sure is that the coordinate direction angle given to us is with respect to the positive x, y, and z axes. For force F3, we see that the angle given to us with respect to the y-axis is between the negative y-axis and the force. We need it to be between the positive y-axis and the force. So we need to subtract 45 degrees from 180 degrees. That gives us an angle between the positive y-axis and the force. Everything else is the same as before. Let's simplify. Notice that our j component is negative. That makes sense since the y component of force F3 is along the negative y-axis. To find the resultant force, we just need to add all of these up. When we do addition in Cartesian form, all we do is add the same components together. So the I components are added together, and then all the J components are added together, and then finally, all the Z components are added together. Don't forget the positive and negative signs for each component we found before. Let's simplify. Now we can find the magnitude. We do that by taking each term in our resultant force, squaring it, adding it together, and then taking the square root of it. Let's plug in our values and solve. now the question is also asking for the coordinate direction angles of our resultant force. For that, we can use these equations. So on top is each corresponding component, while on the bottom is the magnitude. Let's plug our values in. Now if we take the inverse of cosine, we can figure out the angles. Those are our answers. Let's take a look at this problem, where we need to figure out the magnitude and the coordinate direction angles of force F. So when we look at the forces, we can see that force F2 is given to us with coordinate direction angles. Force F1, however, is not. Instead, we're given these shaded triangles. These angles are called the transverse angle and the azimuth angle. So let's see how we can use that to break force F1 into components. So we have the X component, the Y component, and the Z component. When we're given these shaded triangles, we need to find something called F prime. Now F prime is actually this line right here. It's the side that's shared by both triangles. You will see why we need it, but first, how do we calculate it? We're given the angle between the force and the positive Z axis. So using that, we can figure out the angle inside the triangle. That's 90 degrees minus 60 degrees. So the inside angle is 30 degrees. Now let's bring this triangle out. Notice how we can use the 30 degree angle to figure out the bottom length, or rather the adjacent length. For that, we can use cosine. So F prime is this. You can actually use the 60 degree angle already given and use sine, which will give you the same exact answer, but I think it's easier to visualize the triangle using the 30 degree angle. Using the same triangle, we can figure out the K component since that's the height of this triangle. So for that, we will use sine since it's the opposite length to the angle. Now that we found F prime, notice how this is now the hypotenuse of the triangle that's laying flat. So now, we can use the 20 degree angle and F prime to figure out the X and Y components of force F1. So you can see the adjacent length is the X component and the opposite length is the Y component. First, the X component. For that, we will use cosine since it's adjacent. Now the Y component. Now we can write all of these components in Cartesian vector form. Remember to use proper positive and negative signs. Since the Y component is along the negative Y axis, it'll be negative. Now for force F2. Since all the angles are coordinate direction angles, we can use cosine and write it in Cartesian vector form. Let's simplify. The resultant force is then the addition of both of these forces. So remember, all we do is add I components to I components, J components to J components, and K components to K components. Now we can find the magnitude. Let's solve. The next step is to find the coordinate direction angles. So we're just plugging in our coordinates, and on the bottom is the magnitude. If we take the inverse of cosines, we get the angles. Those are our answers. Let's take a look at one last example, just to go over how we can break forces into components if we aren't given coordinate direction angles. So in this problem, we just need to express each force as a Cartesian vector. Let's look at force F1. It's along the XZ plane, which means it doesn't have a Y component. We're given the angle between the force and the X axis. So we can figure out the X component using cosine, since that's the adjacent side to the angle. And we can figure out the Z component by using sine. Now let's write them in Cartesian form. Notice how our Z component is lying on the negative Z axis, so it'll be negative. Let's simplify. Now let's look at force F2. I will draw each component. We have the X component, the Y component, and the Z component. So the first step is to figure out F prime. F prime is the side shared by both triangles. Let's take this triangle out. Notice how we can figure out F prime if we use cosine since it's the adjacent length. We can also figure out the Z component since that would be the opposite side to the angle. So we can use sine. Now using F prime, we can figure out the X and Y components. Let's bring out this triangle. Notice how F prime is the hypotenuse of this triangle. Now the X component is the opposite side, so using sine, we can figure it out. Let's simplify. Next, the Y component, which is the adjacent length, so we will use cosine. Now we can write these components in Cartesian vector form. Don't forget, our Z component is facing down and is lying along the negative Z axis, so it'll be negative. Those are our answers. That should cover the types of problems you will face in this chapter. In the next video, we will see how to express forces that are directed along a line. Thanks for watching and best of luck with your studies.